Good afternoon, students. I hope you all are doing well. In the last lecture, I told you about different sector of businesses, different categories of products. Today, we are going to study about identifying the customer need, defining the market. We'll study about market segmentation, the factors on which the market segmentation depends, like geographic factor, psychological factor, sociological factor, behavioristic factor, one by one. We'll go about it one by one. First of all, we'll start with defining the market. Defining one's own market is an elaborate activity. That means it's a long-term process. It takes time. It is based on a lot of research and pre-testing of prototype. What is a prototype? That is simple. Before launching a product, we do pre-testing of sample products. We show it to small number of people, we take their feedback, and depending upon their feedback, we launch a final product. So before you zoom in on the buyers, you have to understand them as individuals. That is, you have to understand your buyer, not as masses, but as individuals. Their economical, sociological, and psychological profile is defined. Economical means their financial status is defined. Sociological means their background, their ethnicity, their cultural tradition. And psychological means their personality, the reason they will buy your product, their behavior is defined. So let's move ahead and read ahead. The next thing is identifying the customer need. Identifying the customer need. The very first step would be to identify as to what are the features and benefits of the product service that one is offering. What will be the benefits your customer will get when he will buy your product? What are the features? What are the main qualities of your product? So what, basically, first of all, we need to understand what is a feature. Definition of feature is, a feature is a characteristic of a product or a service. I repeat, a feature is a characteristic of a product or service. That means the quality of a product or a service. For example, if one is introducing a new cleansing liquid, that acts as a stain remover for the clothes, then that is the main feature. The benefit to the customer is that they do not depend on the professional laundry service, and it can be conveniently done at their home without any extra effort or money. That could be a good motivation for the customer to buy it. So you understood? Basically, if you buy a cleansing liquid that acts as a stain remover for clothes, then the customer can clean his clothes at home only. He doesn't have to go out and provide extra money to the laundry services. He can do that on his own with saving his money. So that can be a good motivation for the consumer to buy it. Next, by knowing what your product service has to offer and what will make customers buy, you can begin to identify the common characteristic of your potential market. You can know who will be your target consumer, your target audience, by knowing what your product service has to offer. So first of all, you have to figure out what your product is offering, what is the main feature of your product, and then you can identify the common characteristic of your potential market. Next is segmenting your overall market. Look, it's a very tempting idea to target as many people and groups as possible for marketing your product. But there are two major risks involved in this strategy. One is that the message might be spread out in such a way so as not to reach the target group at all, or may reach in a diluted form. That means if you try to promote your product, market your product to everyone, to all the people, then there is a chance that your product might not reach the main target group. And even if it reaches a target group, it may not reach it in the best form. It will be reaching in a diluted form. And second, in order to reach out wider, more content and forms will be included. And that will make the promotional budget very less cost effective, and it will be very expensive. So there were two points. Number one, your message might not reach to your target group. And number two, it will become very expensive. Second, market segmentation is a process of breaking down a large market into smaller segments with specific characteristics.
I'll again repeat the definition. Market segmentation is the process of breaking down a large target market into smaller segments with specific characteristic. So what's the benefit of doing market segmentation? The benefit is it helps to customize a product service and also evolve the advertising strategy to reach the target group. For example, if I am launching a phone in the market, smartphone in the market, you know, and I know that my target audience is youth, and I know that my youth is very much interested in camera and gaming these days. So I'll customize my smartphone. I'll try to make a smartphone with a better RAM and processor so that my customer will be happy to buy the product. Since I already know what my market is, I'll customize my product according to my market. And also the advertising strategy will be as per my target audience, which is youth. So I will make my advertising strategy according to the audience, the target consumer. Another example of market segmentation is the athletic shoe industry. Major manufacturers of athletic shoes have several segmented markets. One segment is based on gender and the other segment is based on the type of sport or activity. They have different promotional campaigns for each market segment. This is very easy to understand. If I'm launching a football shoe in the market, that is a stud in the market, I'll be doing a totally different promotional ad campaign. I'll be keeping my brand ambassador, maybe Messi or Ronaldo. But if I'm launching a cricket shoe in the market, then I'll be doing a totally different promotional ad campaign and maybe I'll be keeping Virat Kohli as the brand ambassador. Also, the second factor on which I'll be doing my market segmentation and doing the marketing ad campaign is gender. If it's a male shoe, then I'll be keeping a male brand ambassador, and if it's a female shoe, then I'll be keeping a female brand ambassador and doing a totally different promotional campaign. So we do market segmentation in athletic shoe industry on two factors. One is gender and the other one is sports. Second topic, how to break large markets into smaller ones. Basically, you can break your large market into smaller ones by four factors. These four factors are geographic, demographic, behavioristic, and last one is psychographic. Geographic factor is basically based on your location. Demographic factor is basically based on the family size, income level, race, age, religion. Behavioristic factor is basically what's the reason for the consumer to buy the product. And psychographic basically is when the customer buys a product, what goes into his brain, you know, what are the feelings which goes into his brain on which he decides to buy the product. Maybe the feeling of elevated status, maybe something else. So we'll be reading about all these four factors in detail in our next lecture. For now, that's about it. Thank you for listening to me.